But the other thing that Hiranbe told us is interest rates. That could be another important determinant of both earnings and markets. And today, of course, we have bond yields now dipping to 7.15, finally registering the good news that foreigners are going to be allowed to buy 59,000 crores. Okay, back to 7.18. There was a brief moment when it went to 7.15. But bond yields genuinely away from that 7.80 mark. What does that mean for NBFCs? We have one of them joining us, Dinanath Dubhashi, Managing Director and CEO, L&T Finance, joins us now. Thank you very much, Dinanath, for joining us. You know, there were two threats to the NBFC business last year after a heady run, that PSUs are back in competition and bond yields have gone up. Both are have gone away. Is life looking very much like 2017 for you?
Good morning to you. You know, both the things that you mentioned, most definitely positives for NBFC, there is no doubt. But business models are made to last much more than these small things. But let me talk about interest rates specifically, especially the policy and a few days preceding the policy, a few good developments. Number one, the state government borrowings definitely coming much lower. To some extent negated by a much higher state government borrowing figure, but a much lower inflation expectation by RBI, supported by the lower inflation prints. As you rightly said, bond yields have corrected significantly. Where does it take us? Yes, definitely the borrowing cost of NBFCs is much lower than what it was 4 or 5 months back. But on the whole, even though we continue the rally to continue at least in Q1, on the whole, FY19 will still be, funds will be costlier than FY18. No doubt about that. In this case, it really depends on each NBFC, how strong it is, how it manages its ALM, how it manages its balance between variable and fixed, and balance between bank borrowings and market borrowings. So it's going to separate the men from the boys.
It's interesting you say that, Mr. Dubhashi. So for your firm itself, some indication, because you're saying that FY19 overall cost of money is going to be more than last year. How much higher?
Oh, that would be anybody's guess. As you know, bond yields are off by at least 60 basis points from their high in October. But there are still, you know, at least 20-30 basis points above what they were, say, a year back. Mm. Also, NBFC spreads had come down drastically. We believe that even if bond yields remain at this level, there would be a chance of corporate spreads and especially NBFC spreads, risk spreads, to harden a little bit from here. Once again, there are different kinds of NBFCs. The better rated ones, a AAA or a AA+, will definitely fare much, much better than the others.
Okay. Give us some indicative numbers. I mean, it's difficult to come to any conclusion on your loan growth, for instance, because all this year you all were battling a low base. So numbers looked very big with 80% and 30%, you know, year on year and stuff like that. What is a normalized AUM growth for FY19?
You're talking about L&T Finance Holdings or NBFC sector?
Both, if you can, but more L&T Finance.
Okay, so L&T Finance Holdings, definitely our loan growth was around 25% last year. The base was not that low. Now we have reached close to 85,000 crores. I don't think we can call it low. Of course, it is low compared to the leading banks, but as NBFCs go, it is pretty high. Let's see on the asset side how things, situations are. Our wholesale book, anyway, we are controlling it. We are not letting the book grow too much by using sell down. But the housing and agri, the rural growth, are actually doing pretty well. The rural market, lots of positives, good rainfall, good expectation of next rainfall, both private as well as government agencies having good, given good forecast. The speed of sowing has progressed extremely well. One small negative is that the mandi prices are below MSPs right now. But most state governments have taken very quick corrective actions on this. Also investing a lot in rural areas through road construction, through MNREGA, much higher investments. And then the proof of the pudding is in eating it. So excellent growth in tractor market, 18%, 15% growth in two-wheeler market. And most importantly, our collections following an extremely good trend as we have completed the year. Okay. So I won't be able to give any numbers right now. That would not be correct. But things have gone pretty well. Mm. And that indicates a good growth, definitely.
Okay. Just a word on the housing side of your business, which is, of course, smaller than some of the other segments. Is that going to be a bigger focus area going forward, or I mean, how do you expect the AUM pie to shape up?
Most definitely. So wholesale today, just a year back, wholesale was 62%. We have brought it down to almost 56% now. And it will further come down, as I have been indicating that by the end of next year, it should be around 50%. As far as rural and housing go, they were about 20 and 25% approximately. Mm-hmm. This will go up by about 2 to 3 percentage points each in the portfolio, just, which sort of indicates a more retailization of the company and the portfolio. So specifically about housing, yes, as you rightly said, our competitive strength or competitive position, if I may, especially in retail housing, is relatively less compared to how strong we are in rural. Mm. But we are gaining scale there, and we are very, very positive about the growth next year.
Okay, can you just give a ballpark number? Margins will continue to be around 7%, and NPAs, can they significantly fall from 5.5%?
So margins, as I told you last time, we measure margins plus fees, which is 7%, okay, as you rightly said. And, even talking about overall margins and with the interest rate increase, this is what I have been advocating, that one way of NBFCs to fight these cycles is have good fee income. And the margin plus fees, we are quite confident at maintaining at around that 7%. NPAs, obviously, I can't say more, but definitely should trend down. Okay. Especially in the rural sector, it must end up, should end up.
Okay, we'll leave it at that. We know we are bound by your upcoming numbers. Thank you very much, Dinanath, for joining us with your thoughts. So that's a positive note coming in from an important NBFC. We are going to continue with that discussion because the terrain seems to be looking back again like 2017 for the NBFCs.